Hey guys, I'm Nick and welcome back to Sci-Fanatics. Today we're talking about Star Trek Picard Episode 5, which is entitled Fly Me to the Moon, which is, I guess, a homage to the old Frank Sinatra song.
Fly me to the moon, let me play up there with those stars.
We're going to go through today a bunch of new promotional production photos that have just come out to promote this week's episode. We're going to have a look through them and see what we can learn about this week's coming up episode of Star Trek Picard. Guys, if you haven't subscribed to Sci-Fanatics yet, please go ahead, click on that big red button to stay up to date and current with all the latest Star Trek news on YouTube. So let's take a look at these new promo photos and see what we can learn. So in the first of our promo photos here, we've got a shot of this astronaut sitting in the cockpit of a space shuttle of some description. Now, this is the character we kind of found out from last week's trailer for this week's upcoming episode, is Renee Picard. So obviously this interplanetary mission that we've been seeing so many billboards for and so forth around LA, promoting this interplanetary trip to Europa, is captained by an ancestor of Jean-Luc. And it looks like Renee Picard here is in the cockpit. This is kind of the divergence that Q is messing with. So obviously this space, you know, mission or whatever got, I guess, human beings to look outward towards exploring the galaxy. And I guess if Q messes with that and puts the mission in jeopardy, then we will become more insular and probably more xenophobic and end up becoming the Confederation. Going by the expression on her face and also the console here, we've got some sort of warning alarm going off. 1202 alarm warning, vector accumulation area exhaustion. Technical issues there with the mission here. So it appears like Houston, we have a bit of a problem in some description in her ship here. Another close-up shot of Renee Picard looking a little bit concerned. And now we get to a shot of, I'm going to call her Laris for now because we don't know the character's name yet, but we know it clearly can't be Laris because she's not Romulan. She's human and she's obviously talking to Jean-Luc in some sort of quaint, almost 70s style lounge room here with a, you know, sailing boat model there on a display. Now, next shot, we see Jean-Luc here. We've got some antiques in the background. It looks like a sort of an old video or slide projector, some sort of sailing navigational tools and whatnot. Another shot of Picard and Laris here with all the different various antiques, the old sailing boat and a few other bits and pieces on the display cabinet here. Sort of a somewhat 70s kind of flavor with all the wood grain and the stylings of the curtains and so forth here. Not to mention the couch and the coffee table, which there's a distinct kind of 70s vibe here. So I wonder whether Laris has taken Jean-Luc. Is it just, have they just transported into a, you know, a different space, or whether this is actually, you know, she's taken into a different point in time, going by the decor, which seems, yeah, very sort of 60s, 70s. Giving Jean-Luc the briefing here about the importance of his relative, Renee Picard. We've obviously got a shot of Renee Picard there on the viewer that she's got up on screen there. She's wearing a flight suit of some kind. We've got the Europa mission badge on her uniform. And I'm guessing that she's talking to Jean-Luc about the importance of his ancestor. Another shot here, this time close up of Laris holding whatever the control panel is she's got in her hands there. We've got the view screen there on the left of frame, which shows Renee Picard. She's obviously you know, a little bit concerned about events and giving Jean-Luc the whole rundown and briefing here. Now we get a shot of Rios on the bus that's inbound to the detention center. Our guard there in the background, who was the one that was giving him a hard time in our last episode. So we pretty much got an idea that, yeah, this episode is the breakout episode where Raffi and Seven are going to do the jailbreak, stop the bus using some sort of EMP pulse with the, from a tricorder and bus Rios out of detention. Now we've got a shot of Girardi. Now she's asleep on a couch in Chateau Picard, and we've got some sort of security guard or whatever with a flashlight in the background there. He's obviously got a two-way walkie-talkie type radio on his vest, so he's probably some sort of security guard that's doing the sweep of the Chateau. Even though the Chateau isn't occupied, it would seem there's some sort of security guard that kind of checks in from time to time, make sure squatters and and other type people aren't kind of residing there. So I'm guessing that Girardi's going to get a bit of a slap on the wrist for breaking in and falling asleep on the couch. Girardi obviously woken up now on the couch in the Chateau Picard, and she's clearly probably explaining herself to the security guard who's discovered her there. Jean-Luc talking to Raffi, obviously in Chateau Picard again. Obviously, this is going to be later in the episode, I'm imagining, because we got to obviously rescue Rios, and everybody's got to get back to La Serena or back to the Chateau again to regroup. This will probably be towards the end of this week's episode, I'm guessing. Now we get a shot of Brent Spiner, obviously in the role of Dr. Adam Sung. Now we saw in the alternate timeline in the second episode this big statue they had on display there in the Confederation dystopian timeline, where Adam Sung was on a pedestal, much like Zefram Cochrane was on a pedestal in our prime timeline. So whatever line of work Adam Sung is in, he obviously has a pretty influential position in this particular time frame. We've got him talking to somebody. We've got a painting there on his desk, which kind of is a sort of a bit abstract, I guess. It sort of looks like a bunch of ballerinas, which potentially could be a child's drawing. I'm going to put it out there and say this is potentially a drawing that we know that Soji, or the actress at least who plays Soji, is appearing in this episode. I'm guessing that she's playing the daughter of Adam Sung. Maybe based on this picture here, she's a dancer or a ballerina or something to that effect, and she's done this drawing for her father here, which he keeps part of place on his desk. Another shot of Brent Spiner as Adam Sung, looking a little bit concerned in this shot. Brent Spiner, as I'm assuming, is Dr. Adam Sung, and he's pleading his case to a board. I'm not sure what the board is that he's pleading his case to. We've got a board of review, a chairman and a vice chair, Dr. Alex Greer, Dr. Diane Werner, who's in fact played by Leah Thompson, who directed our last two episodes, as you guys would remember. And also she's most well known for playing Marty McFly's mum, Lorraine, in the Back to the Future films. And funnily enough, our vice chair on the right of frame in this shot is none other than Dr. Vasily Rashenko. Now, Rashenko sounds familiar, and that's because Worf's adopted human parents, Sergei, and I forget his mum's name, Rashenko was the people that adopted Worf and raised him on Earth or whatever after his parents were killed at the Kidama conference or whatever. So obviously this is an ancient family ancestor of the Rashenko family. The strange thing about these shots here, if we have a look at them, they've got their boardroom table, everything. It looks like it's just in the middle of a hallway. It's not in a room. If we look at the background of Brent Spiner's shot here, they've just plonked a table in the middle of a hallway. And if we look behind our board of directors or whatever they are here, there's just like a stairwell onto the on the left of frame. Someone's just put a desk in the middle of a hallway at the bottom of stairs. It's like, this isn't even in a room in a building somewhere. It's just out in the middle of a thoroughfare, which looks quite bizarre. Who was the art director or production designer on this particular day shoot? It kind of seems a bit odd that you just plonk a boardroom table in the middle of a thoroughfare, like, you know, at the bottom of a staircase here. It's quite bizarre. And here another shot of Leah Thompson talking to Brent Spiner. Good to see Leah Thompson, in the acting department as well. Did a good job of the last couple of episodes in the director's chair. Obviously, she's sitting in the actor's chair for this episode. And I know for a fact that this next episode is directed by none other than Jonathan Frakes. So I always enjoy the episodes directed by Jonathan Frakes. And it's good we've got a bit of Brent Spiner going on in this episode. And we've also got a bit of John Delancey. So that's going to be interesting to see the dynamic between those two characters. So I wonder what Brent Spiner's character Adam Sung is pleading to this board of directors here at some kind of university or, you know, institution or whatever. And I wonder why they're just sitting in the middle of a hallway at the bottom of a staircase and not even in a room, which, it's just seems really odd. Guys, are you looking forward to this week's episode of Star Trek Picard? Leave your thoughts about these photographs in the comment section. Let me know what your impressions are and what you're looking forward to most about this next upcoming episode of Star Trek Picard coming this Thursday. And there's a big sale, in fact, coming up in the merch store starting from the 30th of March, where you can pick up anything in my merch store for four or five days, in fact, where it's going to be 20% off for like a whole 5-day stretch. So make sure you take advantage of that huge sale that's going on starting the 30th of March. As always, guys, please leave a super thanks if you're able to. It really helps the channel out. Much appreciated. A like and comment if you can do that. And subscribe if you haven't already done so. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for my next video. Catch you then.